हेलो गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी हैव एप्लीकेशंस एंड दे आर डिपेंडिंग ऑन द ग्रुपिंग, दैट इज सीरीज ग्रुपिंग और पैरेलल ग्रुपिंग व्हिच वी हैव सीन इन अवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स. फॉर सीरीज ग्रुपिंग देयर इज अ पर्टिकुलर फॉर्मूला एंड फॉर पैरेलल ग्रुपिंग देयर इज ऑल्सो पर्टिकुलर फॉर्मूला. ओके, सो लेट अस सी फर्स्ट एप्लीकेशंस. In first applications, three capacitors have capacitance. So, three capacitors are there and they have capacitance. One is 0.5, 0.3, 0.2 microfarad. Okay? Capacitance. So, C1, first capacitance, it is 0.5 microfarad. C2, it is 0.3 microfarad. C3, it is 0.2 microfarad. So these capacitance, three capacitance are given to us and respectively they are first connected to have maximum capacitance. So in which case maximum capacitance is there? Parallel combinations. Okay, so in parallel combinations maximum capacitance is there and we can easily find out for maximum capacitance all capacitors must be in a parallel combination. So if we draw the diagram for this one, is that is C1, C2 and C3. They have a common potential difference, that is V, having two terminal, positive negative. So C1, C2, C3. If the condenser, the capacitors are connected parallel to each other, then its equivalent is more than equivalent capacitance for series combinations. Okay, so how we can find out if these three capacitors are in parallel? So firstly connected to have maximum capacitance. So here it is not directly given to us, that is they are in parallel combinations. Okay, then we can easily solve. So instead of parallel combination, one word is given, that is maximum capacitance. So when equivalent capacitance has maximum capacitance, so when they are in parallel combinations. Okay, so we know the parallel combination CP, that is equivalent capacitance for parallel combinations, that is the addition of these three capacitors. So what is C1? It is 0.5, 0.3 and 0.2. So the addition of these two, 0.8 plus 2, 1. So 1 microfarad. So this one is the value of CP. Capacitors are in parallel, but it is not given. So maximum capacitance is given. And then connected to have minimum capacitance. So see, minimum capacitance indicates what? They are in series. Maximum capacitance indicates what? They are in parallel. So instead of maximum capacitance, we can use CP. Instead of minimum capacitance, we can use CS. What is the value or what is the formula to calculate CS? So to calculate CS, that is C1 into C2 upon C1 plus C2. So we can put the value of C1 and C2. What is C1 and C2? Instead of this, we can write if two capacitors are here, three capacitors are here. So we can write 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3, which we have seen in our previous videos. That is the equivalent capacitors for series combination is the addition of 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. So CS, that is equivalent capacitance, is exactly equal to 1 by C1 means what? 0.5 plus 0.3 plus 0.2, and the addition of this term will be 31.3. It is approximately equal to 31.3. That is the value of CS, 31.3, that is for 1 by CS, सो इट इज़ 1 by CS इज इक्वल टू 1 by CS इज इक्वल टू 31 upon 3. सो नाउ द वैल्यू ऑफ CS इज एग्जैक्टली इक्वल टू यस द वैल्यू ऑफ CS विल बी इनवर्स ऑफ दिस दैट इज 3 upon 31. ओके नाउ वी हैव टू वैल्यूज विच आर दे सो वन इज फॉर CP एंड अनदर फॉर CS. Now CP stands for what? Maximum capacitance. So we can write here maximum capacitance. And this one is for minimum capacitance in series. So minimum capacitance. So you should remember these things. Okay. Now what we have to find? Find the ratio of maximum capacitance to the minimum capacitance. So firstly we can write maximum capacitance. Maximum capacitance that is CP. Upon CS. So what is the value of CP? It is 1. What is the value of CS? It is 3 by 31. So we will get 31 by 3. So this is our correct answer. That is the ratio of maximum capacitance to the minimum capacitance is 31 by 3. So if you know the concepts then you can easily solve the numericals using this concepts or theoretical background behind it, that is the series grouping or parallel grouping. Now see, another applications is there. In that applications, two capacitors are given to us. So two capacitors given to us. So firstly, we can write that is the given terms. So two capacitors of capacitance, one is 15 microfarad, another is 20 microfarad. So two capacitors, so first capacitor that is C1, it is given 15 microfarad, and second one is C2 that is 20 microfarad, are connected in series and 600 volt DC supply. So volt is given, obviously potential difference is 600 volt. Okay. Find charge on each capacitors and potential difference across each capacitors. Now first of all, I want to tell you that is these two capacitors, they are in series combination. So if we can draw the series combination of these two capacitors, then how we can draw? First capacitor having 15 microfarad, then second one is 20 microfarad. So they are like this. So C1 and C2. So this is the potential difference V1, this is V2. So first of all, we can easily calculate if two capacitors are given and if they are in series, then we can easily find out its equivalent. Okay, how we can calculate its equivalent? So to calculate equivalent capacitance for series combination, we have one formula. 1 by CS is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2, and we can write that is C1 into C2 upon C1 plus C2. So this formula I already told you. So after putting the values in this formula, so we get 1 by CS is equal to C1 into C2. C1 that is 15 into C2 20 upon 15 upon 20. So the calculations of these terms will be, it is exactly equal to 8.57 microfarad. 8.57 microfarad. Okay, so you should remember that is 1 by CS, that is equivalent capacitance, is nothing but just the value of CS. The value of CS will be, so the value of CS, that is the value of CS equivalent capacitance for series combination, it is 8.57 microfarad. Now what we have to find next, that is the charge on each capacitor. Charge on each capacitor. How we can calculate charge on each capacitor? चार्ज ऑन ईच कैपेसिटर CR. सो चार्ज ऑन ईच कैपेसिटर सो CR दे आर इन सीरीज कॉम्बिनेशन इट मीन्स वॉट वॉट एवर मे बी द चार्ज ऑन ईच कैपेसिटर इट इज सेम सो इफ हियर इफ वी पुट प्लस क्यू माइनस क्यू देन वी पुट प्लस क्यू माइनस क्यू मीन्स नंबर ऑफ चार्जेस चार्ज इज सेम वेन द कैपेसिटर्स आर इन सीरीज कॉम्बिनेशंस ओके सो वी कैन इजिली फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू सो हाउ वी कैन फाइंड आउट द नंबर ऑफ चार्जेस बिकॉज वी नो चार्ज इज डिरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस सो देयर फोर वी कैन राइट क्यू इज इक्वल टू सी इन टू वी दिस बेसिक्स वी नो ओके सो दिस सी स्टैंड्स फॉर वॉट दैट इज इक्विवेलेंट कैपेसिटेंस ऑफ दिस टू कैपेसिटर C1 एंड C2 इंस्टेड ऑफ दिस C1 C2 वी कैन कंसिडर दिस वन इज द CS दैट इज इक्विवेलेंट कैपेसिटेंस एंड वी नो द इक्विवेलेंट कैपेसिटेंस क्यू इज इक्वल टू इक्विवेलेंट कैपेसिटेंस नाउ वी कैलकुलेट हियर 8.57 इट इज इन माइक्रोफेरेड सो माइक्रो मीन्स 10^-6 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस इज गिवन इट इज 600 सो कैलकुलेटिंग दिस मैथमेटिकल पार्ट we will get that is 5.14 into 10^-3 5.14 into 10^-3 so this one is the charge which is measured in coulomb so this will be the charge on each capacitor now see here if you know the basic then you will find such applications are very simple But you know all of these things, how we can calculate potential difference, how we can calculate charges. So charge is same when the capacitors are in series. Okay, charge is quite different when the capacitors are in parallel. So here we calculate Q is equal to 5.14 into 10^-3 coulomb. Okay, then potential difference across each capacitor. So how we can calculate the potential difference across each capacitor? Potential difference is quite okay so what is potential difference so potential difference can be calculated by using this formula that is Q is equal to C into V so therefore we can write V is equal to Q by C that is charge upon capacitance so to find out potential difference across each capacitor so potential difference across C1 So here we are calculating the potential difference across C1. So V1 is the potential difference across C1. So what is the value, exact value of V1? So we know this relation that is V1 is exactly equal to Q by C1 because Q is same. Okay. And after putting the value of Q, so what is the value of Q here? So charge we calculate here 5.14 into 10^-3 divided by C1 having value 15 microfarad 15 microfarad microfarad means 10^-6 and the calculating part of this term is 342.7 volt So this one is the mathematical part, okay. So this V1 stands for potential difference across C1. Similarly, we can calculate V2, that is potential difference across C2. So what is V2? V2 is exactly equal to Q by C2. So what is Q? It is same, that is 5.14 into 10^-3 upon the value of capacitance that is C2 is 20 microfarad so therefore we can put here 20 into 10^-6 so calculation part is exactly equal to 257 volt so in this way we can easily solve the numericals depending upon the grouping that is series grouping or we can say parallel grouping so see here so this second applications if capacitors are given to you and if they are in series combinations so you can draw like this circuit diagram and calculate the CS to calculate CS we know the concept that is C1 into C2 upon C1 plus C2 so with the help of this formula firstly you can calculate equivalent capacitance, that is Cs, whatever may be the capacitors are in series or capacitors are in parallel. So Cs is equal to C1 C2 upon C1 plus C2. So firstly calculate the equivalent. After calculating equivalent capacitance, just calculate charge on each capacitor. So we will get here charge on each capacitor is 5.14 into 10 to the power minus 3. It is same because they are in series combination. So for to calculate the potential difference, we must know potential difference must be different for series combinations. Okay, you should remember this, that is whatever may be the voltage, these voltage are quite different. So V1, that is the voltage across C1, V2, that is the voltage across C2. So to calculate voltage V1, we must know Q by C1 and V2 Q by C2. So after putting all the values in this formula, so we will get the potential difference across first capacitance and second capacitance. So in this way we will easily solve the numericals depending upon the grouping, that is series grouping and parallel grouping. I think you understood all these applications. Okay, first applications also simple, second applications also simple, but you must know the concepts behind it. Okay, so we shall stop here. Till then, thank you.